I want to welcome everybody to this week's Wednesday webinar. We really appreciate our friends from Aramark supporting us today. So Aramark, for those of you that aren't as familiar, Fortune 500 hospitality company with clients in education, healthcare, business, government, sports, and leisure establishments. You probably, well, I'm not even probably, I guarantee that you have received services from Aramark, whether you know it or not. And the good thing is that you're going to get to hear a lot more about what they do, how they do it, and what it's like to work at a company such as this. But they have things or positions in just about everywhere across the country and the world, as well as it, like great establishments, as I mentioned, like leisure and sports places. So it's pretty awesome to have them here today. They're going to talk about, first an informational session, and then we have an employee panel, which might be one of the most diverse. We try to hit every service, it seems, at Aramark. We have someone that was in the Army, someone that was in the Navy, and someone's in the Coast Guard. And they're going to talk about, not only, and we have a military spouse, by the way, which I was going to introduce in a second. But we're going to talk about what it's like to be at Aramark as an employee, what type of support there is, what it is that Aramark does. And then we're going to get into a panel discussion with some of these people that I mentioned from the different services are now currently employees at Aramark, and they're going to talk about their transition and how they kind of navigated that and where they're at today and what they can tell you about how their experience has been in Aramark. So without any further ado, I want to remind everybody that this is going to be recorded. And if you have any questions, please put them in the chat. We have people monitoring that, and we'll try to bring them up at the end. So be ready to do that as we're going along. So now I'm going to hand it off to Jennifer Goodman. So Jennifer is a military spouse, and she is also in charge of the Military Initiatives Program Manager at Aramark. So she's our main point of contact, or one of our main point of contacts at Aramark in our partnership with ACP, and is one of the most involved points of contact that we have at ACP. So we really appreciate her partnership. So Jennifer, thank you and welcome. Come on in.
Wonderful. Thank you so much, Rich. And thanks to all of you who have joined today for the privilege of your time. I hope that you walk away with not only a better understanding of Aramark, but also some information that will be helpful to you on your own career journeys. So as Rich shared, I'm Jennifer Goodman. I use she, her pronouns, and I am the Military Initiatives Program Manager at Aramark, where I manage our military-focused efforts and collaboratively work with our talent acquisition and diversity, equity, and inclusion teams. On the DE&I team, I work closely with Isabella Pagana, who is our DE&I Program Manager, to help manage our partnership with ACP. On a personal level, I'm not prior service myself, but I've worked exclusively in military transition and employment for the last 7 years, getting my start with the transition assistance programs and then shifting into helping companies build military initiatives. My spouse was active duty for almost 22 years, and he was active duty when I joined Aramark almost 2.5 years ago. And he retired in late 2020. As far as my relationship with ACP goes, outside of my management of it, I was actually one of the first spouses to go through ACP. And I've now been a mentor to two different military community members. So very, very much an advocate, a champion, and a cheerleader for everything that ACP does. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and share my screen. So that way we can go through, we can talk about who Aramark is and what we do. Are you all able to see that? Perfect. So what you see here is actually our headquarters in Philadelphia. We have operations across all 50 US states, but our primary headquarters is this building that's found in the heart of Philly. So we are a food facilities and uniform services provider. As you can see here, we are a Fortune 500 company. We're actually 235 on the Fortune 500 list. We are found globally, and we have around 248,000 employees across 19 countries and around 145,000 employees in the United States across all 50 US states. So to speak about the work that we do on the food side, we procure, prepare, and serve food for other organizations. On our facility side, we manage and operate facilities. And on our uniform side, we provide uniforms and other workplace supplies for other organizations. So as you can see here, we're a really large organization, and I frequently find that members of the military community haven't necessarily heard of us, but as Rich shared, a lot of times that's because we are embedded in our customers' locations, on their job sites, performing the services that they've asked us to perform, and nobody really realizes that we're not part of the team for the customers that we're serving themselves. So sometimes we're a little bit more in the background providing those services. So one of the takeaways that I want for you to have today is don't let not recognizing a business name or what they do deter you from digging in a little bit deeper to learn more about their opportunities. Because by just going to those ones that you recognize, you can be missing out on a lot of different opportunities. Also, another note on our size, this could end up translating in a lot of benefits to you as well, not only around the robust benefits offerings that we have, but also off of the ability to have a career that you're able to grow limitlessly within a single organization, as well as potentially be able to move for those individuals that maybe face things like PCS or have other life events that pop up that result in them needing to relocate. So we'll talk a little bit more about those here in a little bit. But these three services that we provide, we provide them across a number of different areas, which we call lines of business. Those include student nutrition, which is K through 12 schools, collegiate hospitality, so universities and colleges, healthcare plus, so healthcare organizations, workplace experience, which includes correctional institutions and other businesses. Sports and entertainment, these could be sporting venues, these could be convention centers. Destinations, we are a government contractor and we provide a number of services to the government, including managing the hotel as well as recreational operations on several of the national parks. We provide facility services, so managing and operating facilities, and then also our refreshment services business, which provides beverages and snacks to different organizations. So as you can see, we are doing a lot of work across many different types of industries, and we're doing that across the United States. So this could be that we have not only multiple locations in single states, but also within multiple cities within those states, as well as multiple operations within single cities. So that translates to a lot of different opportunities. And these are some of the organizations that we provide services for. You may recognize some of these. So know that you can still work with some of these companies while being employed with Aramark and be able to take care of these clients as well as their customers. So I just have a little video for you to watch to tell you a little bit more about what we do.
We focus on what great service takes, but at Aramark, we also focus on what great service gives. How that one simple act, the warmth of hospitality, that unwavering attention to people's needs can be a bright spot in someone's day. We go beyond what it takes because we know that every act of service adds up to something bigger than us, something that's remarkable.
Or as we like to say, we create experiences that matter where people work, learn, recover, and play.
We focus.
So taking a closer look at the company, I understand that how a company supports its communities and gives back is really important to a lot of folks. And here at Aramark, we're incredibly proud of the work that we do. So we put this all underneath what we call our Be Well, Do Well plan. And it's our sustainability plan, and it directly connects to our mission. Because we're rooted in service, we do great things for our people, our partners, our communities, and our planet. By addressing environmental, social, ethical, and economic dimensions, we strive to create a better world that enables people to prosper on a healthy planet for generations to come, while also contributing to our long-term business growth. We've taken as an organization significant steps to incorporate equity as a measurable outcome concerning our people, focused on our employees, our clients, as well as our communities. And this includes our military initiatives. Aramark has always been committed to the military community, but I will say that it was last year, with me entering the organization at our enterprise level, that we really decided that we were going to sit down and put very concerted efforts on our military initiatives to bring together some of the incredible work that we had been doing for several years and to put a very pointed strategy behind it. And we've been awarded for some of these efforts that we have, that we've done and that we've made, as you can see here in the slide. So what we're doing for our communities, what we're doing for both our people, our employees, as well as the people that are around us. So we're very proud of these things. It's actually going to get dropped into the chat later on where you can see our sustainability plan and learn a little bit more about the holistic work that we're doing across these areas. And this is some of our 2021 impact. So you can see here how we were able to impact our communities last year. I will say that a lot of this was done through our employee resource groups. And we'll talk a little bit more about those in a little bit. But employee resource groups are groups of employees that many times have commonalities or they have support of specific social identities. And it's through our military employee resource group that we've actually been able to do a number of volunteer activities across the year, and we've been able to make impacts for the military community. So we'll talk a little bit more specifically about that in a bit, but this is a big picture of what our organization as a whole has done. So I want to dive into our careers now. So looking at those, you know, we have the types of positions that might automatically come to mind as someone thinks through food, facilities, and uniform services. So those definitely include culinary and food service. They include custodial and facility services, so facilities managers, environmental services. They include our uniform services as well, which can be production, it could be sales. But behind these primary services that we provide, we have what we call our functional areas. So just as, you know, the Air Force, it's not all pilots that work for the Air Force, right? You have to have support functions that are there supporting the mission, the main objective of the Air Force. And it's the same thing with our organization, that we have to have a number of functional areas that are supporting these primary services that we provide. So those include information technology, human resources, supply chain and logistics, legal and safety. Everything that you see here along the bottom are all career areas that we have. I have seen everything from horse wranglers to corporate pilots and everything in between. And of the 12,000 available jobs that we have, if you explore a career page, you can see that representation of these diverse opportunities as well. So on the careers page, which is careers.aramark.com, there you can actually do a number of different searches. So you can do a search by keyword, but my caution there would be to remember that titles change. So logistics, though it may be a logistics related position, it may not necessarily have that title. So you might do it a little bit broader than keywords. You may search by location. You may search by line of business. You can even go into the what box on our main page and type in remote and review our remote eligible positions. And those range from early career to VP level roles. With 12,000 open positions, I always encourage folks to take a look at the site first, because it can give them a really good understanding, not only of the types of roles that we have, but also the locations of those roles and how they match with personal goals. And this is our reach as an organization. So as I mentioned, we have operations across all 50 US states, as well as these other 18 countries as well. So getting into the work that we do that's specific to the military community, we are partners with the Hiring Our Heroes Corporate Fellowship Program. It is through that program that we participate in the DoD Skill Bridge. And of course, we're a partner with American Corporate Partners. We have around 50 of our employees who volunteer their time as mentors and provide support to service members, veterans, as well as military spouses. I also want to touch on our employee resource groups. Specifically, Salute is our military community employee resource group, but that is one of 11 total employee resource groups that we have. And through our employee resource groups, Aramark works to help enable a culture of inclusion. These groups are employee-led, and they're focused on creating more equitable workplaces and communities. We also have what we call our Ally Network, which is a community of employees to join, that's voluntary for everyone, which focuses on uplifting, supporting, and empowering another person or group. So really, it's through our employee resource groups and our Ally Network that we're not only able to bring together employees to build camaraderie within the organization, but also where we're able to put these teams together to be very impactful in our communities and the communities that are specific to each one of our ERGs. So Salute itself, these are some of the organizations that we've been involved with and that we've supported using the grants that we're able to give as an employee resource group, as well as our time. So you can see here, we've had a Medal of Honor recipient come and speak to the organization for Veterans Day. We're able to spotlight our military connected culinarians. We've been involved with Wreaths Across America for several years. So just a number of different ways that we're able to get our employees involved. So why would you consider us? So a few things for you to consider outside of what we've already talked about. One of them being that we're very mission oriented. Our mission being, because we're rooted in service, we do great things for our people, our partners, our communities, and our planet. For other folks that are mission focused and want to continue to have a mission and an objective and doing better with the work that they do day to day to support others, we are a wonderful organization to continue to consider joining in order to have that for yourself and within your own career. We're focused on empowering our employees. Investing in them, their professional development, and also their career trajectories within our organization. I can give a number of different stories of individuals, including military connected employees, who have started with us and have grown careers spanning, I think the longest term that I've seen is around 25 years. So there's definitely opportunity here, and we want to empower our employees to have that trajectory. Our united teams, we're very much focused on teamwork. You'll always be surrounded by teams that are there supporting you, helping you get the job done, all focused on that mission of that particular group. We talked a little bit about the growth, the unparalleled mobility that you can have, the unlimited career growth that's available through our organization, not only through vertical moves, but also through lateral moves that allow people to grow, to expand their skill sets, and then to be able to move within the organization. Not everything here is linear, and that can be both a little scary as well as a great opportunity. And what we do is we really hope that our managers are focused on providing our employees that guidance so that they can see what a career path looks like, and our ERGs help support that as well. And then finally, the way we value our people. We champion our teammates to bring their whole selves to work, to build a community, and to unleash their potential. I'll say for me, as somebody who started here, has a number of mentors within the organization, folks that have helped me grow myself over the last 2.5 years that I've been here, I can't tell you enough how much I know this to be very, very true. So how can you connect with us? Definitely go to our website, aramark.com. There you can learn about some of the work that we're doing, some of the different customers that we have, and just get a better understanding of who we are as an organization and what we do. As I mentioned, check out that careers page, careers.aramark.com. There you can see all of the available positions. You know, even if you're a little bit out, let's say that you are in the process of transitioning, or you know PCS move is coming and you're exploring what's available next, looking at the careers page even today will still give you a good idea of the types of roles, so that way you can start planning and making connections within the organization. On social media, it's Aramark. You can find us on Facebook, on YouTube, on LinkedIn. And I recommend that no matter the organization, that you definitely connect with and follow organizations on LinkedIn. And part of the reason for that is, for one, it can come up in a recruiter search whether or not you follow the organization for those recruiters that have LinkedIn recruiter seats. But also, it can be a great place for you to get information on what the organization does, what pain points they're trying to solve for, as well as other items that can be great for your toolkit as you're going into an interview. And then finally, for anybody who uses text to apply for opportunities, you can text apply now, no spaces, to 6300, and you can that system will walk you through the process of finding and applying for different opportunities. And for any time that you apply for a position, I recommend that you include ACP as your referral source when it asks you how you learned about the position. That way it alerts our recruiters and myself to your application as well. So just want to leave you with a few key questions to consider before we transition over to our panel. Regardless of whether you're looking at Aramark or whether you're looking at other organizations, think through these things. One, where are you looking to live? I frequently hear, "Jennifer, I'll go anywhere." And my question back is always, there's a big difference between Alaska and Florida. So are you really open to anywhere? And it's not to put anybody on the spot, it's just to really get them thinking. Anywhere seems like it's not going to limit you in opportunities, but you do want to narrow things down a little bit to make it a manageable search. So I encourage you to think through that. If you're focused on portability, think through, does it have to be a remote role initially, or can I start at a brick and mortar location and then look at transferring or moving into a remote role later on? I can tell you that I know of military spouses who work for us that did just this. They started at a brick and mortar and they've converted over into remote positions and have been through 4 PCSs with us. So that's definitely an opportunity, and our sheer number of locations helps support that. What is your timing? When will you be available to start working? These are going to be one of the big things as far as determining when is the best time for you to apply to a position, as well as being able to answer that question when it comes up in any phone screenings or interviews. And then finally, what types of opportunities are a match for your interest and background? What's the right entry point for you? That's not to be confused with entry level. Entry point is just the point where you enter the organization, that role that both challenges you as well as for which you're qualified, that role that can be a stepping stone to build a career within a certain career field or with a certain organization. There are fields that are, or terms I should say, that broadly cover fields like logistics and operations. Maybe dig into that a little bit further. What types of logistics are you looking for specifically? What types of operations? By having the information that I've outlined here, it's going to be incredibly helpful, not only for yourself as you're conducting these searches, but also for anybody who may provide you support that you reach out to. So we're going to go ahead and transition at this time over to our employee panel. I am thrilled to have with us today and to speak with you today, Luis Lopez, Belinda Bailey, and Andy Jeremias. Luis has been with Aramark for 10 years and currently holds the position of Service Excellence Manager on the Refreshment Services line of business. He served on active duty with the Coast Guard for 7 years before transitioning to the Coast Guard Reserve, where he is currently serving and has served for the last 11 years. Belinda Bailey, who uses she, her pronouns, Luis uses he, him pronouns, is a ServiceNow Human Resources Senior Specialist with Aramark and has been with the company for almost 4 years. Belinda has served in the U.S. Navy for 14 years, where she worked as a personnel specialist. After separating from the military, she worked for a finance company as an HR specialist and joined Aramark after completing her master's degree in information security. And we have Andy Jeremias, who uses he, him pronouns, and he has been with Aramark for over 6 years and currently serves as an information technology project leader with our facilities division. He's worked in IT for over 24 years, getting his start on active duty status with the Army. And before joining Aramark, Andy spent 17 years working in IT in the life science pharmaceutical environment. So thank you to all three of them for joining. And I'm going to go ahead and hand it over now to Rich, who is going to serve as the moderator for the panel.
started talking without being off mute. Thank you so much, everybody. First of all, Jennifer, that was probably one of the most comprehensive and well done briefings from one of our corporate partners. So thank you. That was really amazing. I really like, you know, your kind of the way you talked about what, why consider us. That's really, I think that's a question everyone has when they're trying to transition. And then, you know, this idea of, you know, you can work for and at a company or a location that you are really into, but also be an Aramark employee there, whether it be a college or a sporting venue or something like that. So that was kind of neat to see. And the key questions to consider were spot on. We see those all the time. And I think those are great pieces of advice. So thank you for that. Now I want to, where they came from and how they got to where they're at. So I'm going to start with Luis. Can you just give us a you know, minute or two on yourself, where you're at, where you're from? Give us an introduction.
Yes, of course. Well, good afternoon, good morning, where depending where you are. First and foremost, thanks everyone for your service. Greatly appreciate it. And yeah, I mean, I've been with Aramark now for 10 years. I got out of active duty back in 2010. And I started working for pretty much a competitor. It was kind of like a difficult transition, right? Not knowing going from driving boats to pretty much delivering uniforms was a big difference. And I say that because what Jennifer brought up, it was an entry level, right? And I met someone there who had moved from that company to Aramark and gave me a phone call and said, "Hey, I think I have a better opportunity for you." And here I am in Aramark. So I came to Aramark as a route manager for the refreshments division of Aramark. Worked my butt off, you know, doing all the dirty work that whatever it takes, always being there for the team, always a team player. And the opportunity came up to work for the operational excellence team. I applied for it, went through all the interviews. They saw everything that I've done in my role, and they gave me the opportunity, and I've been doing this for 4 years now. The OPEX team is pretty much a team within the corporate level, and I partner with the country is divided into four sections, and I help run the business with a vice president of operations for the Northeast region of the United States, and I'm in charge of making sure everyone from a manager levels doing what they're supposed to, right? So check and process, make sure, you know, all the process is being followed, and right, other special projects that come along the way. And it's just about adaptability and making it work for myself and the region and overall just the Aramark.
Oh, great. Luis, that was a great summary. I really do appreciate the fact that, and I agree with you, wherever you land, you work hard, it gets recognized, and then there's room to grow and move around. And sounds like Aramark's a good place to be able to do that. Belinda, can you tell us about yourself a little bit?
Hi, everyone. It is so nice to be in the company of so many military members. I haven't been around this many people from the military since, well, the last time I was there. My name is Belinda. I'm a 14-year Navy veteran. I was stationed in Guam. So after boot camp, you know, it asks you, where do you want to go? And I put Italy, and they sent me to Guam. Never heard of it. It was like a dot. I was so mad. I was like, what? And I cried for like the first 3 months. And then I realized I couldn't swim back home. After Guam, I tried. And I was stationed on ship. From my 14 years in the military, I've been out to sea 10 of those 14 years.
Wow.
The other four I spent it in Norfolk, Virginia. So yeah, it's so transitioning from military to civilian life, I really wasn't used to being on land for such a long, extensive time. And I moved back to Philly. I'm in Philly from Virginia because I wanted to be home. When I got out, I felt lost. I was the only one there. I wanted to come home. I didn't want to be around military people anymore because it was a little sad not being, feeling like if I don't belong to that community anymore. Not true though, not true. But you know, the transition period from that to civilian life, it's real, it's like a roller coaster. But I got back to Philly and I went to work for a financial company and it wasn't a good fit for me. They didn't understand my background. They didn't understand my experience and they didn't understand how to interact with me. So it was a very uncomfortable 3 years and I did not feel appreciated there. I applied at Aramark and I felt so welcome. I felt like at home. I felt like I was around people who understood me. And so I've been here ever since. Love my job, used my GI Bill, went back to school, got my master's, and then I started off as just a regular HR specialist, and now I work in the IT field. I kind of do a hybrid. I do HR because I know HR, and I do IT because I know IT, and I think Aramark gave me that opportunity to do both, and I love it. I don't think I would have had this opportunity at my other company, but being here, I get up every day and I'm happy to go to work. Not just do I have the ability to do what I like, but being a single mom, that's one of the reasons why I had to separate from the military, because, you know, it's not really for single parents. And being a single mom, Aramark offers me that great work-life balance. So don't tell my boss, but I haven't been in the office for the year and I'm supposed to. I have a desk there, but they give you that flexibility. You do your work just like the military, you know, you show up, you do what you're supposed to do, you get the respect, you get the appreciation, and Aramark offers me all of that and a free desk. So that's it for me.
Oh, well, hey, Belinda, that was some great information. And honestly, your story is not any different than a lot of stories we've heard about, you know, the anxiety of transitioning, trying to find the right place to land, right? That's why we hope our mentorships with ACP can help make those decisions so you don't have to transition two or three times within the first few years you're out. But it's very typical. And so we really appreciate your honesty and hearing your story. And last, we have Andy. So Andy, you want to tell us about yourself and how you got to where you're at?
Andy, you're muted.
Oh, I'm sorry.
There we go.
Good afternoon. Yeah, so 17 years prior to joining Aramark, I worked for a competitor company in the pharmaceutical environment. So did have that military kind of standard and bearing, also a lot of the stress that came with it. So I was approached by a recruiter that offered me a position where very similar. I have the IT background and the facility engineering. I was a combat engineer and then roped into 25 Bravo and 20 security information IOPS. So I had those two skill sets. I was able to support the facilities operations here at Aramark with IT corporate. And the reason I picked Aramark is I liked the mission of it, where they were going, especially tactically with technology and looking forward with how businesses should start deploying devices, technology apps, which are now showing, coming to fruit, because years ago we talked about it, but now we're starting to implement it. So that's another reason I enjoy working for Aramark, is they execute on the decisions and make it happen. So, but it's been great working with a lot of the programs. I'm part of Salute. We've done some great volunteer work during our ABC days, restoring veteran homes for veterans and building gardens. We've done all types of community service, and a lot more community service, I think, for the veterans in the community than I've done for my previous employer. So it's another big benefit I've seen with how Aramark has embraced the military community. I'm proud to be a part of Salute. I am also my first mentorship with ACP. It's been really a great opportunity. I was a little concerned. You know, I was an E6 and he's an E5. You know, how could I, you know, mentor an officer? But I was a DARNS officer, duty detention officer, NCO and officer in my unit. So I look back at my military experience and how I could use that as a mentorship. And he's been working out great. He's actually got a good position. He's very happy. But I see where he has his questions, concerns, just moving into the corporate world. You know, we have our own acronyms, you know, but very, very similar operations and structure that I think the military community would feel at home at here at Aramark.
So. Great. Thanks, Andy. I think I heard this, but I want to make sure for everyone that you guys tell us how you got into or heard about Aramark. So Luis, you said a buddy poached you from somewhere else, huh? Is that true?
Yeah, so he was actually my first civilian boss after getting out in the previous company. He was hired here in Aramark, and then he reached out to me.
All right, it's a good testament that he, one, thought highly of you, but also thought that Aramark would be a good fit for you. So that's good for both of you, right? Melinda, was it because Philly's home and Aramark has headquarters there?
Yeah, they had the biggest building in the city, and I wanted to get in.
No, that's you got to be comfortable. As Jennifer mentioned in her slides, and I really appreciate that, you really have to consider where you want to be, and for whatever those reasons are, that's important to you and probably your family. So that's great. And Andy, what about you?
A recruiter reached out. I think he picked up my LinkedIn page and my matched up my experience with facilities and IT and especially the military help too. So I'm outside of Philly. I take the train in, and I did have a desk before, but I can work from home or I can go into headquarters. But that was at first, concern of, I'm going to go in the city. I'm out in Downingtown, Pennsylvania, but it's really worked out. And actually, it's good to get out of the house and be sometimes with team members, obviously, and be on. And there's also opportunities where I've been deployed with projects and other important incentives. So
that's great. Yeah, that's definitely important. And it's nice to see that you have the options there. For sure. All right. So what about what kind of suggestions do you have for other for the people out there that are in there searching? What would you suggest they do when they're looking for opportunities? And if someone can, I'll let you all take turns on this one. But if someone can address maybe timing, if they have a suggestion, because there was a question Lee had about, he heard, 3 months out is probably the earliest that you want to reach out to apply to some of these companies. Anybody want to jump in there?
Rich, so I would say take advantage of all the help you could get while you're still in trying to transition out. The mentorship program that you guys have is is amazing. I enjoy it. I enjoy getting candidates all the time, right? Helping them out, answering all the questions. And we're here for you guys, right? It's not you're bothering with questions or anything. No, that's what we're here for. And we volunteer for that. We volunteer to help you guys out, right? ACP is a great company, and we're here for you. So that's the first thing you should do, get on that mentorship, because you could go deeper into questions, more detailed and stuff like that. And we're here to answer it. We also work with different lines of business. So refreshment services may not be what you want to do, but I could easily reach out to Belinda or Jennifer or Andy and say, hey, my candidate has, a question in regards to IT. Can you guys answer it? And, that's what we're here for, and vice versa. And then also, get your resumes up to date and pretty squared away, right? That's also huge for me. when I'm looking into hiring someone, right? I mean, we all know military people are great team players. You know, they're reliable and they have a lot of adaptability, but make sure you get all the recognition of all the hard work you guys did in the military and put it on paper so someone could see it. That's what I have on that question.
All right. Andy or Blenda, wanna chime in?
Yeah. Everything Luis said, I want to reiterate what he reiterated, but what I would like to say is, do not assume that because you're a veteran and you come out into the civilian world, that's an automatic pass. Nobody cares if you're a sharpshooter or if you're qualified, and they don't. So make sure you take advantage of this program here and get your resume squared away. It's challenging or it's difficult sometimes transferring your military experience into a language that they understand in the civilian world. Our jargon is different. The acronyms are different. I learned the hard way. This program here, I wish I had this when I was transitioning. This program, you have people who can help you with your resume, how to type it, you know, what languages to use. We've been there, you know, we've done it. You don't have to go through all of those difficulties. So as Luis said, you know, get your resume squared away and network. Reach out to people, use LinkedIn. You know, just message somebody that you go through and you look for the type of job that you want to get into. You type it in on LinkedIn and then you see somebody, there's a lot of military people on there. And you just message them, hey, you know, I'm in this service. Can you tell me how to get into, you know, this line of work or this field of work or to one of us? But network, 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 update your resume and do not fall into that false comfort thing of I'm a veteran, but as soon as I get out, they're gonna hire me because I'm a veteran. It doesn't work that way. So that's my piece.
That's great. Andy, anything to add?
Boy, they pretty much filled it out. I would definitely say use your confidence that you have, your experience and the confidence you gained from the military. obviously we have a leg up on other civilians that it could be, you know, you might have certain skill set that obviously only the military has, you know, trained you on. So look for those opportunities, but don't be discouraged if you don't find a job that's going to match your MOS. And maybe even talk to your spouse, your significant others, because you now have the choice. You're not being forced into a job or a station or a unit. You can, you know, make your decisions and not have Uncle Sam make it for you. So I definitely would say take advantage of the open opportunities and maybe do some prep, job prep interviews. Have maybe someone coach you. If you know a friend as a manager, there's practice tests online. The basic kind of questions they're going to ask you, why do you want to work here? What's your experience? Those prep questions that you'll be asked during the interviews. And also your resume and LinkedIn and Indeed, any of the network and online social sites. That's how I landed my position. So I highly recommend keeping that up to date.
I think you all hit just about everyone that I've heard most often, which is the networking, which is seems to be really key these days about getting your foot in the door. But you can't even get looked at sometimes if you don't have a decent resume to start out with. So I definitely agree with you all on those things. Jennifer, you came out. I saw you come up, but did you have anything to add?
No, just getting ready as we move over into Q&A.
Yeah, so we are going to move to some of the questions. So please, if you have any questions, put them in the chat. I have some questions that were submitted ahead of time that I'm going to start throwing out there. And since Jennifer's back on and she hasn't talked in a few minutes, I was going to open up one of the questions that was submitted ahead of time, which is, what is the hiring process at Aramark? What does it require? Does it have a sponsor at Aramark help? You know, does that tell us how to get in there?
Yeah, I'll take this one. So it definitely starts with that careers page, exploring, seeing what opportunities are available. And I'll preface that the panel has spoken about networking, which is incredibly important. I'm speaking right now about the process that you began, the traditional process that everybody has to go through. We are a federal contractor, so everyone has to apply for the position. They have to go through the process. But that starts with reviewing our opportunities, identifying a role that could be a fit, and then going in and submitting your application. If you click apply now, you'll see the button on any of our positions that will walk you through the process of creating a profile in our system and being able to upload your resume. The number of interviews that you do is really going to be contingent upon the type of role within the organization. If it's an individual contributor, if it's a manager, there's a number of factors that impact that. So it can vary, but for most folks, you're going to start with a phone screening where you're going to have a recruiter call you. It's going to be a 15 to 20 minute conversation. And really what they're trying to identify during the course of that chat is whether or not you meet the minimum requirements for a position. Before you apply to any role, my suggestion is actually to scroll down to the bottom of the job description to look at the required qualifications section to see whether or not you meet those different qualifications. If you don't, you may consider looking at some other opportunities, but that's going to be a really big portion of it. And that's going to be what that recruiter is focused on. You know, if it states that you need to have a bachelor's degree in engineering, are you able to say that you have that, for example? If it says that you need 2 years of this specific experience, let's say it's ServiceNow experience, like Belinda has, you know, they're going to be looking for that. And if you don't have it, I highly recommend being able to speak to what you do have that puts you near that requirement. So that's going to be the step one. From that point, once that recruiter has determined that you meet the minimum qualifications for the role, they will send it forward to the hiring manager for review, and that hiring manager will make the determination on whether or not to schedule an interview with you. From there, it's really just dependent on the role, as I mentioned. If you're ultimately offered the position, everybody does go through the background check. That typically takes about 3 weeks, and then early on, there will be an agreed upon date of when you're available to start, and that'll be reflected in the offer letter. Another question that came through was about when you should apply. I do recommend not applying more than about 90 days out from your availability date. We post a position when we have a need, and we look to fill it as soon as possible with the most qualified individual. So obviously, that can take a little bit longer, but they are usually looking for somebody who can get started pretty quickly. Now, this is not to say that you shouldn't network with other folks in the organization. As Belinda mentioned, you can definitely go through. You can find veterans who work for Aramark. You can find myself, who is kind of a low-hanging fruit for military-connected folks to reach out to. And you can start to have those conversations, start to network your way in. And that can be a catalyst for finding out about opportunities that aren't posted. But the traditional way, that would be the process.
Great. Thank you. I'm going to go back to the other members of the panel and just kind of, some of you touched on it a little bit, but can you, you know, tell me what you think is the best thing about the culture at the company? Because I think culture is one of those things that maybe military members, I know myself, I really didn't think about it much when I was transitioning. So, but it turns out to be one of the reasons why people end up not staying or staying at a company. So anybody have any good information to talk about with the culture at Aramark and why you like it there?
Yeah, Rich. So I'll give my opinion on the culture, right? We are, quote unquote, in a corporate, you know, part of the corporate world. However, I think Belinda covered this when she was describing it. We're huge worldwide. However, when it comes down to a local level, we try to keep it almost as a family. And we understand each other. We're there for each other. And I'm not just saying this to drink the Kool-Aid here. It is true, right? And I personally been in situations of family related, you know, medical issues that I've had to take some time off and stuff like that from work. And, you know, it's not, oh man, this guy's gone, we got more work. No, it was more like a pat on the back, go handle your family, go take care of your family. And we'll handle whatever needs to get handled here for you and when you get back. So that's kind of the culture here. And we always, you know, and I travel a lot for work. I'm always on the road. And just with that, the the balance between work and life balance is always amazing, right? I could tell you that I've been able to move some travel arrangements just to be at my daughter's violin concert in school, and it's okay. So just to that level of how we see each other and how important it is for to make it a great place to work. And I could see it across the country, at least in my division. And when I work with other lines of businesses like dining and stuff like that, from the conversations, it's pretty much the same.
Great. Anybody else want to throw anything in there about culture?
So for me, for Aramark, well, three things. One, I got out of the Navy because my daughter had surgery on a Thursday and they sent me on deployment the Monday. That broke my heart. But I didn't have a choice, right? They say, oh, we don't give you your kid in the sea bag. So that mm-hmm. broke my heart. And I was like, I can't do this. I have to make, you know, a decision. This first job I got when I got out, they weren't very flexible. I had to be at work for 8. My daughter's school doesn't start until 9. So I had to wake her up at 6, get her, you know, she was out of the house and they were not flexible. That bothered me. I didn't like it. So at Aramark, if my daughter's school starts at 9, I tell my boss, you know, I'll drop my daughter off to school. I'll come in. If she's sick, because I'm a single mom, and I say, I have to leave to go get my daughter. Okay, that's fine. When you get home, just log back on whenever you can. And if she's sick for the rest of the week, just work from home. That flexibility where I don't have to make a choice between going to work or taking care of my child, right? Any parent, you put them in that position, they will always, always choose their child. The fact that I did not have to make that choice anymore is one of the reasons why I'm at Aramark and I will remain here until my daughter graduates high school. And then I'm kidding. I will stay here because they make me, the people I work with, my team, they're very, very understanding and they got my back. I like that, you know, they got my back. So Aramark is to me, my group is like a family. It's not just a place I go work and, you know, they give me a paycheck. I'm there because I want to be there. I feel valued and they make me feel really good about what I do. So
that's great to hear. Andy, I don't know if you can top that, but.
I know, you guys are stealing all the thunder. I think the recognition of the different, there's all the different groups that Jennifer showed the slides from Salute, Pride, and the African Women's League. I'm sorry if I didn't pronounce it right, but all the different organizations, which all are different cultures, and it really feels that we all are part of that team of the diversification, and it's a really good feeling to be part of the company, especially here in Philadelphia. It's been won awards after one after another for you know, top employer of the year, for not top, but it just a lot of incentives also with programs to help with wellness if anyone's dealing with any, you know, issues with mental health, as well as any type of you know, any financial or assistance. So it's all different types of programs to reach out to all types of different families throughout the country. So and also the opportunities of learning and being able to continue my skill set. So.
Right. Yeah. I think that those are all things that sound like a great place to be is Aramark. So we're about maybe one more question. If anybody has something in that wants to put something in the chat, the time is now. I would want to ask maybe Jennifer, if you can quickly, you know, nowadays people are interested in what their remote opportunities are. I know that you did discuss it and both Linda and Andy said something about it, but is there certain, is that listed in the job description? Is it to be assumed? How do we find out about that?
Yeah, that's a great bridge question for me, Rich. You know, in regards to my connection. So as I mentioned, my husband was active duty when I started. I was actually found by a recruiter and recruited to Aramark, and my husband was active duty. So they allowed me to be a remote employee so that I could join the organization while my husband was active duty and I couldn't move. And they've allowed me to remain in that capacity since then. So they knew I was a military spouse, and that was was just always so meaningful for me. So if you're found, those conversations can be had. If you apply to a position on our careers page, if you go into the what box and you type remote, leave the location blank, any of our positions that have been earmarked as remote will populate and you'll be able to go through and explore them from there.
Okay, and then the other ones, other portability, it depends on, where you're at and what's going on, I guess, right?
Yeah, some roles may be hybrid, some of them may be remote. And then from there, you know, if it ends up coming up, particularly for our military spouses, if there's a PCS that's being faced, that's when it would be the time to have the conversations with managers to see, you know, can my role be converted into a remote position? Can I transfer to another location? All of that is, of course, there's a number of pieces that will impact that. Exactly where are you going? What have you done? What are you looking at? But definitely opening up those conversations with managers. As I mentioned, I know of several other spouses in the organization that have been able to maintain careers with us that allowed them to take them with them when they PCS'd.
Great. Well, I think we're going to go ahead and close it up. First, I wanted to thank Alex, who's been my silent partner in this. He's did a lot of the legwork or all of the legwork behind the scenes of getting this organized and working with Jennifer and the team to get us where we're at today. I always love coming to these because I really do learn a lot about not only the companies, but what people should look for when they're looking for job opportunities. And I want to thank our panelists and Jennifer for a great discussion. And so please remember to link in or connect with some of the people that you saw here speaking today and do as they said about networking, ask some questions, ask people what it's like to work at those companies, and it'll take you to the next step as you're going through your transition. I wish everybody luck in their transition, and thanks again, Aramark and crew. So have a great day, everybody.
Thanks, everyone.
Thanks, everyone.